मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई टेक अप द नेक्स्ट वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज फॉल्ट्स इन द ब्रेड्स,
ब्रेड फॉल्ट्स
एंड देयर रेमेडीज.
यू नो दैट ए गुड ब्रेड शुड बी जज्ड बाय द वॉल्यूम,
ब्लूम, शेप, टेक्सचर, शीन, मॉइस्टनेस एंड फ्लेवर. One should examine the external and internal area of the bread to find out whether the bread which you have baked that is good or not. Bread faults can occur small step during the processing,
and
these small faults after the interaction together make big faults, or independently some big fault can also take place in the processing of bread making. There are number of factors which are responsible for creating faults in the bread. For example, if the flour used is weak, it is not having sufficient amount of gluten content, you are not using the proper proportion of the various ingredients which are to be used for bread formula, the diastatic activity of the flour is poor, fermentation time, temperature, relative humidity of the proofing cabinet, they have not been as per recipe, they have not been maintained properly, or there is a wrong method of manipulation during knockback, cutting, slicing, rounding, proofing. Manipulation has not been done properly, then
you can get some faults.
Inadequate cooling of bread after baking has been done, storage of bread is improper, or the food handler is not aware about the proper hygienic practices while handling the bread, while storing the bread, while selling the bread. All these can cause different faults.
There are so many faults,
but the important ones I will be taking up in two parts. In the first part, I'm taking a major fault which we have observed in the breads, that is regarding volume of the bread loaf. Volume of the bread loaf, that is the outcome of adequate conditioning of gluten and sufficient gassing of the dough at the time of baking.
You can get a small volume bread,
you can get excess volume. These two both are the faults. You should get the proper volume of the bread. If the volume of the bread is low, there are many factors responsible for the low volume. For example, number one, when you are doing the mixing of the ingredients for bread making, then
you have done under
mixing, you will get a tight dough that will give you less volume. If the amount of yeast
given in the recipe
has not been used properly, you have used less amount of yeast, you have kept proofing time less than the desired one, fermentation time is less. If the
temperature
of the oven is low, then in the proofing cabinet, final proofing has not been done for the sufficient period. Diastatic activity of the flour is low. Then if the flour is having bran contamination, ash content of the flour is more,
under mixing
or over mixing both can give you low volume. Similarly, if the, I have said, baking temperature is low, very low, or if it is very high, both will give you low volume. If you add more amount of salt in the mixture,
you know, it inhibits the activity of the yeast, fermentation will not be proper,
and you will get less raising of the dough and therefore less volume of the this bread. If the amount of fat shortening that has been used in less amount, that is also responsible for giving low volume.
These are some of
the factors responsible for low volume of the bread loaf. You can go into it in your case, what is the cause, and then you can rectify that cause.
Sometimes we find that bread volume is in excess, and as a result,
you will not get the good crumb inside the bread.
And that excessive
volume is also because of many factors. First, if you have done over fermentation of the dough,
you have added less
salt in the formula, and yeast goes on doing its action, fermentation, and it is not controlled or checked by the presence of sufficient amount of salt. And naturally, you will be
over
fermenting the mixture. Then
when you are molding the bread
and panning it, the molding is loose.
It has not been
molded
properly.
It has not been sealed properly. Then in the oven, temperature is low. You have put the bread not in the preheated oven. These all factors, they are responsible for giving excessive bread loaf volume.
And these are the common
problems, common bread faults you find, and you should look into the
reason for it
and try to rectify accordingly.
Then we take up the next bread fault. This is regarding
crust color of the bread. You know that if
the crust color
is
good, it will be attractive.
You would be
happy to
see it. You will like to eat it. And if it is very pale in color or it is too dark in color, that is not desirable. The crust color can be too pale sometimes, and the factors which are responsible for causing too pale color, number one is sugar. Sugar, that means you know that crust color is controlled by sugar, and due to caramelization it gives golden or brown color to the products during baking. If the sugar is in less amount in the formula, you will get
pale crust color.
And if you will be using too much of sugar in the formula, that will give you dark crust color.
Then if
excessive amount of yeast has been added,
then you know that if
sugar is the food for yeast, and yeast will convert this sugar into carbon dioxide, ethanol and some acids, and therefore less sugar will be available for the caramelization of the crust to give it a golden brown color during baking, and that is the reason you will get
the pale crust. Then
if the temperature in the oven is insufficient, proper baking temperature is not there, then the
crust will be pale in color.
Under baking has been done, baking for less time than the required time, oven temperature is low, it is not preheated, diastatic activity of the flour is less, you are using old dough. These all factors are responsible for the pale crust color, which is not desirable. Then
regarding crust color,
another fault is that it is too dark.
Naturally, the all the
factors which are responsible for giving the pale color opposite of those are responsible for giving the dark crust color. For example, if you add more sugar in the formula, even after utilization of sugar by the yeast, there is sufficient sugar
left for the caramelization
during baking. It will give dark color. If you are using more milk in the formula, milk sugar, milk lactose, that is also responsible for giving the color. If you are doing over baking, if you have to do baking for 20-25 minutes and you do it for 35 minutes, naturally the crust color will be very dark. Temperature, you have to maintain it 220 degrees centigrade or 225 degrees centigrade for bread making, but you have kept it 240 degrees centigrade for more time, that will give you dark crust color. Excessively fermented and conditioned dough has been used. It's an old dough. You can get
dark crust color.
These are very common bread faults which we generally find when the students are working in the lab while bread baking. And all these, if the sugar is too high, correct it to the
low sugar
content as per the formula. Similarly, diastatic activity has to be improved. We don't have to do the under baking. We don't have to
do
baking at a higher temperature than the recommended one. Then if we know the cause, then we can control that and can remove that fault. Then next
fault, third
fault, that is leathery crust, leather type crust. The crust of the bread, you know, it should be very crisp. It
should easily
break. If the crust becomes tough, it is not easily pulled, that means it is leathery.
It may be because of
insufficient conditioning of the gluten, or if the crust absorbs lot of moisture. Sometimes we do the baking in the steam
ovens and
there is more steam,
and the
if
water content
is absorbed by the crust during baking, then it will give you
leathery crust.
Another fault, blisters under the crust.
When you slice the bread,
you will find that under the crust it is having blisters.
That means
it can be due to overproofing one has done. We were supposed to do final proofing for 30-40 minutes so that it comes up to the 3/4 level of the baking tin, but you have done for about 2 hours, 1.5 hours, and it flows the baking tin.
Excessive steam or humidity in the proofing cabinet. It is not
between 70 to 75 percentage. RH is more. If we are handling the ingredients or the process in an inappropriate manner, we are not doing the proper handling during baking,
it can give blisters. If bread has been baked
in excessive
humidity in the steam ovens, molding, when we are doing the molding of the bread, if we have done very tight molding, we have done molding under pressure because it is tight, then it will give blisters. Under all these situations, what will happen, the moisture will deposit on the surface of the bread. And due to the increase in the moisture content, the gluten of the affected areas, that will acquire more stretchability, and this will form blisters under pressure. When the gas will expand during the baking. Sometimes molding
is under pressure or it's very tight. Some air bubbles will be entrapped during the
molding under the film of gluten.
If it is tight, then these air bubbles, they will expand during the proofing, and when you are doing baking, then it will give blisters under the crust. Another important bread fault, that is very thick
crust of the bread loaf. There are few reasons for this.
Again, if you are using less amount of shortening in the formula, less amount of fat in the formula, you are using less sugar content in the formula, you are using less moisture during proofing,
low oven temperature,
if you are doing over baking, all these factors will give you
very thick crust and
it is not desirable. In this class, I have taken up some of these important bread faults and their remedies. And in the next class, I will take up rest of the bread faults. I hope that you have understood them properly. And if something is not clear, please
don't hesitate. Connect to me,
and you can raise your queries, and I will be happy to respond to them. Thank you so much.